victims and their families, and we respect their coming forward and the testimony that she's offered in this trial. We also have a tremendous amount of respect and gratitude for the good work and investigation by the Constitutional Department of the United States.
The reality of this national epidemic has hit home, and there is overwhelming sadness that we have for the large number of students suffering from sexual violence every day in this nation. Today, a measure of justice has been served for victims of sexual violence. While he was not convicted about all charges, Owen LaBrie was held accountable in some way by a jury of his peers for what he committed against her daughter. This conviction requires him to take ownership for his actions and gives him the opportunity to reflect upon the harm he has caused.
In a larger sense, the convictions are important because they send a message to the community at large and certainly to the academic community that young people who are sexually abused by campuses, the perpetrators are going to be charged, they're going to be prosecuted, and sentenced and punished.
He understands that the jury acquitted him of every charge that alleged that he engaged in any contact with the complainant without her consent, as well as any charge that alleged that he engaged in conduct by surprising her, she was unable to voluntarily. In essence, what happened as a result of this trial is one teenager was found guilty of having consensual sex with another. This was a very difficult case because Owen's own statements to this. I think the critical evidence was not the testimony of the complainant, it was the testimony of Owen given when he was talking to his friends.